How do I use the web reader activity in UiPath? That is what we are going to see in this video. Hi everyone, welcome back to the next video in the UiPath Generative AI activity series, where we are trying to understand the UiPath Generative AI activities in a step-by-step manner by building some of the use cases. My name is Mukesh Kala. I am now a 5-time UiPath MVP, Certified Solution Architect, and also a LinkedIn top voice. I have shared my LinkedIn details on the page. Feel free to send a connection request. Happy to be part of your network. Also, you see a small QR code on the screen that is for our WhatsApp community. You can scan the QR and join the WhatsApp community, where we have a lot of other developers in the group. And you have any questions, any doubts, you can ask in the community as well. Also, whenever there is a new video getting uploaded, you get a direct notification on your WhatsApp, right? So with that, let's get started. Okay, so in case you are directly coming to this video, I would highly recommend you to watch the previous videos of this playlist so that you have the background, you have the context to understand today's activity. I have posted the playlist link in the description for your reference. Okay, so the activity today which we are going to discuss is called the web reader activity. This would be a continuation of our last video where we have used something which is called web search, right? Now, in the last video, we have seen that how the web search activity was able to give me the URL for some of the specific websites, right? Now, if using the generative AI activities, I want to read the content from a URL, how can I do that? That's where you have this activity, which is called the web reader activity. The web reader activity is designed to specifically extract the textual context from the pages which are available publicly. So in a use case where you have some URL and you want your automation to grab that data and use it in the further processing, you can use actually this activity, which is called the web reader. Okay. Now, to better understand the activity, I am going to present you some of the use cases where you can actually use these activities, and then we are going to UiPath Studio and going to utilize the activity. Okay. So the first use case, you are an RPA developer and you want to quickly obtain a summary of some pages. It can be a news article, it can be any article, or it can be simply some sort of a document which you want to summarize, but that is available on the website. Here I can use this activity, which is called the web reader activity, and I'll just provide the URL and it will be able to give me that information. Once all of that information you have, you can always use the other GenAI activities which we have seen, and you can use it in the other set of automations. Okay. The second use case is, students often need to gather information about the courses which are provided by the university, right? Now I can just provide the courses landing page of any university, I can provide it as an input, and then I can simply write one liner statement that give me the list of courses which are available in this content, and it should be able to get me that from the URL. So as a human, as a student, I do not need to spend time and reading the complete thing, right? It can be something like summarize a research paper from an online journal. So you are a researcher, you are a student, and you want to summarize some articles. Again, the same concept, just provide the article link here and it will be able to summarize that thing for you. In the previous, we have seen other generative AI activities, which means that today, if this online journal is in, let's say, a different language, French, German, but you want to convert it to English, you can also do that with the generative AI, detect language. You can use the summarize, you can use the web. So basically what I'm saying is, by using combination of all the activities which we have seen in the past, we can actually build a more concrete use case, right? Last one, obtain the company profile from the website. Now I have a company profile and I want to know what this company do. So every company has something which is called an about us page. It has a lot of details. I can simply provide all those URLs directly to this activity. It will read it and then I can generate the summary out of it. How cool is that, right? And the last one is extract details from a conference page. This one is interesting, right? So for example, there is a conference which is happening and it has a very huge agenda. Now you want to know the specific one. Let's say there is an event which is happening and you want to know that does it cover anything for RPA UiPath developers, right? You can provide the URL of the complete agenda to this activity. Ask it that, guys, just a simple prompt, is there anything which is for RPA developers? Use it in the automation and get the output, right? So by just using one or two activities, you would be able to cater more and more use cases. So now with all these background about the activity and some of the use cases in mind, let's go back to UiPath Studio and see all of this in action, right? I would be doing it practically. So I would request you to please open your UiPath Studio. It's absolutely free. You don't need to pay for any credits and you can still use your community edition as well. If you build along with me, you will definitely had a good understanding, right? So with that, let's go back to the UiPath Studio now. Okay guys, so this is the same solution which we have been working throughout this playlist, right? In case you are directly coming to this video, you can always create a new solution and you just need to ensure that you have this activity in place, which is UiPath.integration services, that gives me those activities, right? And in case you don't have this, you can just drag and drop activity and that will also add the dependency for you and make sure that you are connected to the orchestrator. Okay. Now with that, let's go here and I'll try to create a new sequence, right? I'll call this sequence as web reader and I'll say create, right? In the last one, we have seen that how I can just write a prompt and I can do a Google search and it was able to give me the URL. So once you have the URL, maybe from the previous use cases, you can still use this activity and read the content of the URLs as well, right? So now the activity which is today we are going to use is the web reader. So for that, I simply go to this one, which is the activities, and I'll just search here web reader. Okay. In case you are not getting this web reader, you might not have the dependencies. So just make sure that you have this checkbox here, which is available. Drag and drop the web reader here and it should automatically add the dependencies for you. Okay. Now, all of this is coming from the generative AI activity pack. So I think there is some issue with my connection. So I'll just go here and I can say which connection I want to use, right? In case you don't have this connection, you can click on this button and say add new connections. I already have the connection here. So I'll just select that connection, right? And this is the connection which is available. Now, if I talk about the search engine, as of now, I only have Gina, but in future you might have more. Okay. Now, it is asking me, Mukesh, give me a publicly accessible URL, right? So any URL which is publicly accessible can be provided to this activity and it will get me the details out of that. Okay. To give an example, I have this article, or I would say a news article which is available, which is called from BBC, which says Britain's 5 best slow train journeys, right? So if I have this URL, again, you can get it from the web search activity, right? Now, if you go back to your UiPath Studio, into the URL, all you have to do is just provide that URL. Okay. So for simplicity, I'll just go here and I'll take assign activity. I'll drag and drop it here. I'll hit Control plus K and I'll say that this is my input URL. Okay. Now into this, I'll just provide the input URL into the double quotes because this is a string. Okay. Now, once this input URL is here, all you have to do is just pass the variable like this, right? And that gives input to the web reader activity. Now, if you go to the properties, which is this one, right? There has been some changes in the layout as well. This is the latest 2025 version of UiPath. Okay. Now, if you see here, we have one text, which is the output. So I can just go here, hit Control plus K, and I'll say output underscore text, right? And that should give me the text into this variable, which is the output. Okay. Now, what I'll do is I'll just go here and I will use an activity called write line. And then I'll just say that print the output text. That's a simple activity. Okay. So if I just go here and I say run the file, what should happen? If everything works as expected, it should go to that URL, and from that URL, it should get me that details that what exactly that page has, right? And if I just go to this one, this has some of the information along with some images, right? So let's see. As you can see, this green indicates that the automation has started. Yeah, we'll just wait for it to complete, and then in the output we have this one, right? I'll just copy this and take it to a notepad, and this is what the complete thing is available for me, right? So whatever is the article, that article is completely available in the text format for me without me opening the browser, extract the information. I can just provide the URL and it gives me these details, right? Now you might have a question that what I can do with this text, and that is where I want to show you this complete list of activities which we have been covering, right? So if you would see, right, so for example, today you simply want to summarize the text, you can just go here and use an activity which is called summarize text, which we have already covered, and you can just summarize the text. For example, if it is in a different language, you want to detect the language, you can use detect language. After the detection, you can actually go and say translate. You can actually use it to summarize some of the bullet points. You can also use it to extract some of the information. You can ask question on top of it, right? So that completely depends on your use case. So for today, let's say my use case is that I just quickly want to summarize all of this content. So for that, I'll simply go here and I will just use something which is called a summarize text, which is also GenAI activities already covered in the past, right? So here I'm saying that I want to summarize the text. I'll again provide the connection, and then it is going to ask me, what do you want to summarize and how? Okay, so I want to summarize the output text which I have got from here, which is the output text, and then how do you want to summarize? I want to summarize it in a bulleted list, and then I want to keep it blank. Okay, and then whatever is the output, I'll just go here and I'll say that the summary, I want to create a variable which is called summary, and that summary I want to get here into a bulleted list, right? So I'll just go here and I'll say a right line, and into the right line, into the right line I'll just say the summary, right? So basically what I am doing here is, by using a combination of generative AI activities, I am first reading the content from a web page, then I am asking it to summarize, and then give me a summary in a bulleted list. Let's try to save this, go here and say run the file, right? Now I do not want to read the complete article, I just want to go here and wanted to know that what exactly is this summary into bullet points. Okay, completed. Let's go to the output, and this was the article, and if I go to the output, the summarized output, this is the summarized output. Now this was the actual output, I'll remove this, and I copied the wrong one, but here it is, right? So basically it says that this is the summary. So now I do not have to read the complete article, I can just read this summary, that as England celebrates this, here is the top five slow train rides in includes overall favorite, most picture, most fun, and it has given me a pretty nice and clean details, right? So without reading the complete article or whatever the news it was, I just go and I got these details. How cool is that, right? Now to continue that same thing, right, let's say today I want to know about any new product of UiPath, let's say UiPath Maestro, right? UiPath Maestro. So I can pass the URL of UiPath Maestro to this, which is the input URL, into the double quotes, pass it here, and use the same automation where I'm saying that I want you to read this complete this page, right, and give me information about what exactly is this thing, right? So let's go here and try to run this file. Okay, so now I am just using the summarization with the help of detect, translate, web reader, web search. You can cater to a lot of different use cases, and I'm pretty sure that by just watching this you would have got a lot of more ideas. Okay, so let me just go to the output, And here it is, right? Which says that Maestro addresses the complexity of enterprise's workflows, the key features, it has the significant benefits, and it has given me a pretty neat summary of the complete page, right? Now, depending on my use case, I can use this input into the further processing. Let's say I am I have created a website where I'm just used to summarize. I can even, let's say, write this as a LinkedIn post. I do not want to read the complete article, but I just want to provide the details. I can use this, right? And a lot of different use cases can be catered with this, right? Okay, so I believe that this was helpful and you have got more use cases in your mind. Okay, so with that, I am wrapping this video here. I would highly appreciate your feedback on this content. Any more questions, any more doubts, feel free to write me in the comments, or you can also drop me an email as well, right? So with that, wrapping this video here, thank you for watching. If you like this content, make sure to subscribe to the channel, and see you in the next video. Thank you for watching, and happy automation.